you'll love it. I have some fun things today. Okay. First of all, yeah, have a seat. Have a seat. Oh, I love when we, our kids have reunions. They're giving each other nice hugs. We'll make room. There's room for all of you. I love it. Oh, my goodness. Well, I have something with me. You don't have to pay attention to the word on it, but can you pass it to each other and tell me just how it feels? Does it feel real solid? What is it, actually? Is it like a rock? Yeah. It's not squishy, is it? No. It's real solid. Do you know that sometimes, as people, we can become solid as a rock? In our brains, in our thinking about certain things. We can tell, like, sort of stories in our mind about certain things. Like, somebody one day might say to us, gosh, you're really pretty, or you're really handsome. And we might pass the rock back. We gotta pass it this way, too. And we might really make that frozen like ice or like a rock, right? And believe that. Another day, what if somebody said to us, you're really ugly, you're not good looking at all? Sometimes we can make that really solid too, can't we? We can fixate on that, like it's really hard, like a rock, and we can freeze it in our brains. Does it help us to believe those stories? Or are they just stories? Jesus, life in Jesus tells us that sometimes maybe it's more helpful to be like, what in the world do I have here? What is this? Want to touch it? Oh, it's kind of oozing and goozing all over, isn't it? What is it like? It's slime. I hear that kids are really into slime right now. Are you into slime? Any kids here play with slime at home? That was my next question, Remy. Because I hear girls your age that you just made slime yesterday. It's fun, isn't it? What's the best part about slime? How stretchy it is. It changes shape. Go ahead, Zoe. What were you going to say? It's calming, right? Because just when you think, oh, like that rock, it's going to be one shape forever. It moves. It changes, right? That's just like our thinking. We get stuck sometimes when we think, when we make things really solid. I don't know, like this rock. We make it like ice. We freeze something. Sometimes we can freeze an idea about ourselves or others, and it just sometimes hurts. A rock can hurt us if we threw it at somebody, right? When we freeze our thoughts, we can hurt ourselves sometimes with them. So life in Jesus is to realize the truth that we're more like slime. Things aren't so fixed. They're actually changing all the time. And the fact that they're changing all the time, we can feel afraid of that. Yes, you can touch it, or we can feel really soothed by that. Like, if just because I feel this way right now, maybe doesn't mean I will forever. Just because somebody called me a name right now doesn't mean it's true. Or maybe I called myself a name. Maybe it's not true. It helps us challenge some of those stories that we tell ourselves. There is one thing that we do know is the only thing that's always true. What do I have right here? A heart, exactly, a heart rock. Can you read what it says for me on there, Remy? That's right, it says, keep Jesus in your heart. Because the only thing not changing all the time, and the only thing that can't hurt us if we get stuck on it, is the rock of Jesus' love. I have something for all of you today. Can you help pass those around to the kids to me, Miss Meg? Every kid gets a rock. Guess what? Every adult gets a rock. This is supposed to be your touchstone through Lent to help remind you Jesus, to keep Jesus in your heart. That's the only rock that we should be making solid, the only idea. The rest of it is going to come and go and change. And we're going to explore more of that in our sermon series in Lent. Go ahead and take one. Will you pray with me before you go to Sunday school? Ready? Open them, shut them. Open them, shut them. Give a little cheer. Woo! Open them, shut them. Open them, shut them. Raise them by our ears. Dear God, thank you so much for being the rock of our love. Help us to be more like slime, squishy and changing and soothing and realizing everything changes but your love. And all God's people said,
Amen.
Thanks so much for coming up. Have a great week and a great time in Sunday school. Oh, no, you get to keep it. You get to take one and keep it. Did you get one? Do you have one? You do. Good. All right. You can stay right there. It's a special day for your family, isn't it? Oh, jeez. You can tell that I had one less hour of sleep. I'm actually pretty impressed. All of you look like you're doing pretty well. Good morning. Welcome to worship this morning. An hour earlier, we are in daylight savings time, but you know what? It's a good thing because it means that we are in Lent, which means the lengthening of days and spring. It means that spring is just around the corner. We have a few announcements today. One, first of all, I would like to invite Hadley Dots, family and friends. You can see, you want to hold up this beautiful girl in front. You will see her in a little bit. It is her special baptismal day. And we are so excited. As you can see, we have some special little gifts for you here today. A bib and a blanket that our knitters made for you to remind you of this day. And we will call you up with your parents and godparents after the sermon so that we can baptize her. A reminder that this is live streamed, so if you're missing anybody today, it'll be archived later. You can watch it later. Or you can text them quick. If they go to emmanuelcederberg.org, they can live stream now and be sort of with us even though they're far away. We have some things on the calendar. As I mentioned, we are in the Lenten season. We share midweek Lenten worship here this year with our friends of faith. It's a great tradition we look forward to every year. And so Faith will be joining us for worship. It's really a time for congregation members to shine. They have spectacular skits that are often hilarious. And yet, especially as we get increasingly closer to Easter, they are very poignant in helping us think about what journey we are on as we journey toward the cross and towards Easter Sunday. So know you are welcome to join us at any time. If you have to miss, we're also going to be live streaming those, and we'll post those later, so you never have to be left out of that. We invite you also, we have a soup supper that begins at 6 p.m. I heard we do need some still signups even for this week, or we take 3 of the weeks, and I think Faith takes 2 of the weeks. We take turns hosting one another with soups. If you have a good soup, bread, or dessert you'd like to make, please do sign up. I know you're welcome. You don't have to come every time. You're welcome to join us anytime you're available. It really is a nice evening. Easter flower orders. Here we go. It's the first Sunday in Lent, and I'm telling you, our deadline for ordering them is March 31st. You know that the church never looks so beautiful around here as it does for Easter. And that is a testament to all the flowers that you helped to order for us. That you can then plant later in your garden. So please do sign up to do that if you are able. We have the fish fry coming up this Friday. It is at Fire Ridge, so you don't have to make the fish. We go to Flannery's Fire Ridge in Fockville. All you have to do is sign up, and it's a nice evening out. So I think today is the last day to sign up, though. We just need a number so that we can tell them how many people to provide for. Some people sometimes tell me, but Pastor, I hate fish. It's okay. I think there's like a choice of ribs or chicken or other things if you're not a fish eater. And you don't have to get it fried either. You can also get it baked. That's what I always do. Yoga is still going strong. The class is growing a little bit. So know that that's an option for you on Mondays. Bible class is on. Thank you. Huge thank you. I can't believe it's a week ago already. We had so many people turn out to help with our pig roast last weekend, and it was so awesome. As you can see, we made, I think, probably the most ever for our profit. Total profit, $2,643. $1,799 of that from the pie auction alone. There's some good pies around here, right? How was that lemon meringue there, Mark Larson? Did you get one piece? Right, who comes with the sheep? Really? Okay. Uh-oh, Joanne. Yeah, I think that's probably good because Cindy wants more pie for herself. But let's give a round of applause to all those volunteers. Because, let me tell you, it took a village and they had fun and they worked so hard. And we appreciate it so much. Do we have any birthdays, anniversaries, or special celebrations today? Birthday. Oh, what? Tell me your name.
Ken.
Ken's birthday today. Anybody else? All right, well, let's sing happy birthday. God bless you to Ken.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
your people through the wilderness and brought them to the promised land. Guide us now as we call upon your name, trust in your mercy, and live for your glory.
Today's reading is from Romans 10, verses 8 through 13. The word is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we proclaim. Because if you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For one believes with the heart and so is justified, and one confesses with the mouth and so is saved. The scripture says, no one who believes in him will be put to shame, for there is no distinction between Jew and Greek. The same Lord is Lord of all and is generous to all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. This ends the reading.
Please stand for the reading of the gospel. Our gospel lesson this day comes from Luke, the fourth chapter, beginning with the first verse. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit in the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing at all during those days, and when they were over, he was famished. The devil said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command this stone to become a loaf of bread." Jesus answered him, "It is written, one does not live by bread alone." Then the devil led him up and showed him in an instant all the kingdoms of the world. And the devil said to him, "To you I will give their glory and all this authority, for it has been given over to me, and I give it to anyone I please. If you then will worship me, it will all be yours." Jesus answered them, "It is written, worship the Lord your God and serve only him." Then the devil took him to Jerusalem and placed him on the pinnacle of the temple, saying to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you to protect you. And on their hands they will bear you up, so that you will not dash your foot against a stone." Jesus answered him, "It is said, do not put the Lord your God to the test." When the devil had finished every test, he departed from him until an opportune time. The gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, Christ. Please be seated.
Will you offer a prayer of love and kindness in the name of Christ? First of all, for yourself. Give yourself a break for just 1 minute this week. If no other time, offer it right now. For a beloved one or one who may be in need of your prayers. For a neutral person, I ran into this lady at a store yesterday, and she was having a very difficult time, a clerk. And I might have never seen her before, but she has been on my mind. She was in my meditation and prayer last night, and now I'm telling you, here she is today. She's popped up. Maybe you have someone like that in your life that you pass and you pass and you never see, but you saw them this week. Offer a prayer for them. For someone you are struggling to love, or like, or even tolerate right now. And it can be the person who cut you off in traffic, or maybe you're ready to work with someone who's more of a challenge in your life right now. And for all beings everywhere, with whom we are inseparably interconnected, who want and need the same way that we do, may we be safe. May we be happy. May we be healthy. May we be at ease in our hearts with whatever comes to us in life. May we rest in a peace that passes all understanding that we find in Jesus. May we know the power of ones living and loving with fearless, open hearts. May we know the sweetness of our own being like this little baby Hadley Dot, that is still in us, this baby Christ, looking out our eyes at one another. May we all together complete the spiritual journey. Amen. So I'm doing this sermon series in Lent. It was the most popular one I ever did at the last church I served, Gloria Day. It's, of course, tweaked a little bit because I'm a different person now. I'm with different people, and yet there are some themes that sort of remain the same. And the theme is releasing the dream. And it's kind of, I talked about it Ash Wednesday, so for those of you that were here, just hold on with me a little bit. I tried to talk with it about the kids a little bit. We got a little distracted by the pretty rocks and by the slime. But the idea is we can get very fixed in dreams that we had for ourselves, for our lives. And we start to tell ourselves stories about them like they are absolutely a rock, like frozen water, like ice, like they are so true. And we live this way day after day after day, and we don't challenge them very much. And sometimes we can become stuck as people because of that. So releasing the dream helps us kind of to live, like I said with the kids, more like slime. This was a more popular. We originally thought of just getting that as your favorite for Lent, and I wish that we had stuck with that. We ended up getting the hearts. And the fact is that, you know, the one solid thing is the love of God, so, you know, no apology for that. But people have been asking me all week, PV, can I get another slime? So somebody's having fun with it, including me. Look, it's stuck to me right now. I thought this week it would be fun to take sort of a funny one. I know, it's stuck. It's okay. It's coming back in a little bit, so just, you know, get used to it being around. Sort of one that is playful that we can talk about. And after the last service, you would not believe the men and women, actually it's women maybe less surprising, but men, that came up to me and said, I haven't challenged that thought in a long time. And I can't believe how much I believe that. But it's one that releasing the dream that I will ever reach my goal weight. Does this resonate with anyone here? Yeah, I see a lot of nodding men and women out there. And maybe that's changed over the years. I mean, maybe when you were younger, it was a different weight. Maybe when you're older now, you know, it's different. Maybe it's one your doctor now has given you. And don't hear me saying one thing. As I go through this sermon, I'm not talking about not being a healthy person in that, you know, we don't do our best to find a way to live as healthy as we can, okay? That exercise is important and living in balance. But it's sort of the middle way. We don't really challenge the fact, and it's kind of funny that Jesus is fasting in the desert, because I bet some of you have tried to fast, you know, like me, or every diet that's out there. I think right now the new incarnation of Atkins is the keto, and Weight Watchers, you know, they just lost a lot of money, but they'll probably swing back when everybody eats a carb again, and we've all heard this, right? We've all been there, and it's a billion-dollar industry selling to us all the darn time that we should have a target weight, and then, when we reach it, we will be happy. We will be attractive. We will have everything come to us in life that we ever wanted. Our dreams will be fulfilled. It's just so alluring. And this starts being marketed to us very young. I mean, maybe it was older, you know, when we were older in a while, but those of you with young kids, particularly young girls, they say now with iPads and different things, the joys of the things they can bring, the things they can learn, the Googling they can do when I had to look in an encyclopedia forever. It's great. But they also are seeing and hearing these images ever sooner. And they're taking cues from our attitudes about ourselves. So I remember when I was in about my confirmation age kids' grade, I found this when my parents were cleaning through, you know, the stuff that you leave behind in your room. Anybody there yet? Like, please take your stuff. And I must have been 7th, 8th grade, and I had made a notebook. And this is already back in, you know, the 80s, before airbrushing, we knew what it was and that they were doing it, or it was even much of a thing. But I had cut out in magazine letters. Now you can make a meme, but then you had to cut it out. Happiness will be when. And then I flipped through the book, and it was page after page of supermodel and their perfect whatever body part you think it is. And, you know, face and hair. For some of us, it isn't necessarily weight. Maybe for you, it's, I've always had curly hair and I wanted straight hair. I've always had hair and I really like the bald look. I got went bald way too soon. I didn't want that. We all have our thing that is about appearances, right? That we don't realize we're telling ourselves this story about when happiness would be, and yet it is so alive in our daily life when we get up and we look in the mirror and we talk to ourselves and we talk to ourselves about, I will be happy when. And the truth of the matter that Jesus is getting at today, I love that we start with this text right now for Lent, because it's so insidious. It is such a lie. This morning I was so tired, I couldn't come up with Aaron Rodgers. That every guy, if you don't look like Aaron Rodgers, or, you know, make as much money or play football like him, like you're okay. Or for every woman, the magazine page that's advertising for you today, or that woman that posted a picture, you don't have to compare yourself against and feel bad like I'm different than that. That's something I've had to work, you know, at my earlier service. Some of them have been around longer, so they've been working with this longer. But it's one of those things that I remember, I've always been, I'm built differently. A heavier person. I was a heavier cheerleader, okay? But I still did it, because I loved it. I've had to battle that idea of, I'm the one in my family who works out and watches what I eat, and here I am. Think about how often this goes through our minds. What if I told you today you could release the dream that you will ever find happiness, that you will ever achieve, now this is supposed to make you laugh, but that weight on your driver's license, and that even if you get to goal weight, because things change in life, it's going to change. You're going to eat something salty or a carb again, and it might change. And happiness can't be found in that. Somebody sold us a line of goods. Billions of dollars they're making on it. Billions! I'm relying on the fact that we feel bad about ourselves about this and obsess about it. So I'm challenging that today. Because it's so insidious, it's really what the devil was doing to Jesus today. The devil shows up and says, as if the devil has any authority on Jesus' worth, or that Jesus is God or not. All these broad statements like, well, you will only be God if you do this, if you turn the rock into bread. Only if you soar off the companion, only if you believe in me. Believe it or not, a lot of people, a lot of maybe failed messiahs at that time, a lot of us, we buy the goods. And Jesus stands so firm in the moment. He sees right through us, right through it. He can see the God in him that is. And the joy that is available right there, fasting in the desert right now, and that all the rest is just an illusion. He's chasing after. It's an appearance that he has, we can have this fixed idea. Oh wow, the slime's really taken over here. I think it's trying to show us the point as it crawls down the ambo there. Do not put your worth to the test of all these things. Think about little kids. Look at these little kids right up here right now. When they see each other, when they play, they may notice differences in sizes or shapes or colors, but do they have a judgment about it or their worth or an idea of, oh, if I were only this, I'd be happy? Or are they just happy with who they are and what their body can do and what they are right now? It's a revolutionary idea. And it's one that I think, what would happen if we released that dream? Now I know we're going to walk out that door, and just like you, the story's going to come up again. Probably in 5 minutes, when we're challenged by like a cookie sitting out there, or whatever it is. But notice, can you just notice what runs through your head then? What story are you telling about yourself and your happiness and your worth? How solid is it for you? Might it help if it be like this creepy crawling slime instead? And let it just go. And realize the only thing fixed and solid about you is in the heart touchstone. I hope if you haven't taken one that you do. Is the story of God's love in you that says to you, you can be happy now. It's not something that changes with your weight or whatever it is. It's here now. You can release the dream. My goodness. We are so beautiful, so loved by God. It shines out our eyes all the time. Believe it. And at this time, to show us a living example of this beauty, this natural great perfection in us all, I invite Hadley Dodd and her parents and godparents, and if the kids, if you want them to come forward too, that's fine, to receive the sacrament of holy baptism. I'll have you come stand here behind the font so everybody can see you, and I'll get out of the way because they don't really want to see me. They want to see beautiful, perfect Hadley on this day, just as she is. God, who is rich in mercy and love, gives us a new birth into a living hope through the sacrament of baptism. By water and the word, God delivers us from sin and death and raises us to new life in Jesus Christ. We are united with all the baptized in one body of Christ, anointed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and joined in God's mission of life for the world. And so this day, called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace of love, do you desire to have your child baptized? If so, say we do. As you bring Hadley Dot to receive the gift of baptism, you're entrusted with responsibilities
to live with her among God's faithful people. Bring her to the Word of God and the Holy Supper. Teach her the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments. Place in her hands the Holy Scriptures. Nurture them in faith and prayer, so that your child may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, care for others and the world God made, and work for justice and grace and peace. Do you promise to help Hadley Dot grow in the Christian faith and life? If so, say we do. And sponsors, you have a very special role. Do you promise to nurture Hadley Dot in the Christian faith as you're empowered by God's Spirit to help her live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the church? If so, say we do. People of God, do you promise to support and pray for Hadley Dot in her new life in Christ? If so, say we do.
We do.
I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God? If so, say, I renounce them. Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? If so, say, I renounce them.
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? If so, say, I renounce them.
I renounce them.
Do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. All right. At this time, we'll do the service of baptism. You can hold her. It's either way, but it's fine if she's doing well. Hadley Dot, I claim you for Christ. Your name is forever written in the book of life and on the palm of God's hand. All right, we're going to take a little bath. You want to put your fingers in here first? You want to feel it? All right, Hadley Dot, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. That's your baptismal water. Good girl. There you go. Hadley Dot, this is how we want you to live. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me has the light of life. So let your light shine before others that they may see your good works and glorify your God in heaven. We welcome our newest Christian member, Hadley Dot Rifke.
Thank you.
mercy and love of Almighty God, we offer our prayers for the church, for people in need, and all creation. Holy and steadfast God, keep your word near to us, planting it in our hearts and communities, including Bishop Paul Erickson and the Greater Milwaukee Synod, and our partner churches, Incarnation, Faith, Trinity, St. John, and Advent. Make it blossom into proclamation for all people to receive. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. As you give your spirit freely, so also give bread that sustains every living thing. Graciously feed hungry souls and hungry stomachs with your bountiful provision. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Stir up courage among your people to resist oppressive powers and to lead people into freedom. Shine the light of your justice through their work. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Hold tightly to those who grow weary in their struggle with addiction, temptation, grieving, or illness, especially Glenn, Shirley, Kirk, Wally, Greg, Kay, Roger, Anita, Tom, Kelly, Randy, Margaret, Bill, Judy, Alice, Nancy, Vernon, Rich, Tom, Kelly, Jerry, Surya, Kelly, Carol, Diane, Willie, Lorraine, Mary, Leslie, Carly, Jim, and Abby, and all those we name silently or out loud now. By your strength, bear up to live fully in your presence. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Teach us the stories of faith by heart. As you accompanied our ancestors in their uncertainty, so guide us confidently into the future. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. When we struggle and are tested, redeem us by the endurance of Christ. Give us steadfast faith to strive for your glory until we witness its fullness. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. We welcome Hadley Dobkrafke into our family of faith through baptism today. May we all love and guide her and support her family on her journey of faith. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Reveal your will as you receive our prayers. Confirm our ways to your ways through the saving work of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We receive our offering.
Thank you.
night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He blessed it and broke it, gave it for all, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, blessed it, gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "Take and drink. This is the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We pray together the words our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come, for all is ready. All are welcome for communion. You guys have to be so bad. I'm a marathon course here.
Christ's joy, right?